Yo, what's up? My mullet sharp here, and today I'm bringing you guys search and destroy tips on Dome. This is what you guys have been asking for in the comments. This is going to be part of the pro tip series, as alongside the slaying tips and the objective tips on the CTF modes. I'm going to start doing S&D tips on all the maps. So, what I'm going to be covering in this series is rush routes, nade spots, and defending spots after you plant the bomb. I'm also going to go over your open breaks and where players should be sitting during the sides on offense and defense. So, hope you guys like this. You guys have been asking for it, and let's get into it. All right, so first we're going to start with the outside spawn. This is going to be the defensive spawn on the outside of Dome. You're going to spawn over here by this forklift. Now, the first thing you want to do, tell everyone on your team before this map starts, you're going to go over your strats and everything, what you're going to do, if you watch this video and emulate what I tell you guys to do, and it works, and that's all good. So, but the one thing you want to make sure you do, no matter what your strategy is, no matter where people are going, is whoever spawns in the front of the pack, and that's in front of everyone. He's not going to be the guy all the way in the back getting bumped by everyone, getting in people's way. The guy in the front is going to want to switch to an extreme conditioning submachine gun, and all his job is to is run full head of steam up the middle, try to get to the sidewalk right here. He's gonna have the best chance of not getting stunned, not getting naded, not getting shot, and he's gonna have the best chance of getting control of the sidewalk position, which is really extremely a good position to have during the middle of a search and destroy round, stopping people coming out of the loading dock area. All right, now the next person on your team is gonna want to be one of the people going over here to B. Now the thing I like to do is I like to come right out of Dome, push right behind this forklift right here because people are gonna be stunning. So you're gonna want to stun over towards the loading dock area. If you stun anyone, call it out to the guy in the middle sidewalk and sit behind these forklifts for a while. If no one rushes down, then it's probably safe to move over here to the right. Try to get positioned either behind the bomb or behind the satellite, because if you get behind the bomb or satellite, you can kill people sitting out here. A lot of people like to sit out of the right side of the trailer right there and try to look through and kill the guy middle sidewalk, so you can help him. You can kill people poking out to the left, people trying to push up through the Humvee, and after a while, if you see no one out of the loading dock area, then you can try to push up to loading dock and get this little position right here, and then you're going to be set up to trap them inside and force them to go A.
Search and destroy. Defend the objective.
Alright, now the third guy on your team is going to want to be the guy that goes into A. You got to have someone watching B, you got to have someone watching A. So, it's just going to be this guy's job to go A. Me personally, I don't like to go A, but someone has to do it. So, tips here. You got to watch out for people stunning in through this hole. So, I recommend to go all the way into the back over here and then just kind of try to wait down here, wait it out, in case people like to rush down these stairs or rush down this hole. You can crouch right here and get behind this head glitch. Look over there at the stairs, look at the hole, and after a while, then maybe you can try to push up these stairs, but I don't recommend it because you can get naded or you can get shot from the window. So I recommend just trying to stay more over here behind this area, and if you are going to push out, maybe push out a hole, get behind this, or push behind these Humvees and head glitch right here. This is a good head glitch. So if you can get control of that position, it's going to be easier for you to lock them in. You have the other guy pushed up on the far right at the trailer, got sidewalk, you're in the middle, and you're going to have them locked in their spawn. That's a big killer on this map, is winning the defense, because it's so easy to trap people in the spawn. Offense on this map is nearly impossible, so as long as you guys can do that, then you're going to be in good shape. Alright, now as for the last guy on the team, I recommend this guy runs an ACR and stun. So off the start, while people are running up middle, people are running B, people are running into the left and A, what this guy's only gonna do is stun over here by the Humvees. He's gonna stun their front door, make sure people can't rush into A, run down the stairs, run down the hole, kill the guy in A. So off the break, stun, stun, and then what I like to do if I'm ever playing in this spot, I like to come up top ladder and then lay down right here. Use an ACR with impact or just an ACR with focus. Lay down right here and pre-fire, or not pre-fire, but just pre-aim over by the door, over by the Humvee door. You know, you can usually sometimes kill people poking out, and a lot of times they won't see you sitting back here. And if you want to get a little risky, then you can come over here and lay down. You can lay down right in this spot, and you can't be seen from the left, so all you can see over there is the loading dock side. And if they're going B, you can hub your teammates over at B, kill them at loading, and maybe if they do rush B, you can come up top and try to pick up one of them off. But you got to be careful up here because this spot can be seen from everywhere on the map, so it's not really one of the best spots in the game, so you got to really play it cautious. Alright, now time to go over the other side on the break. Now this is going to be very similar to the outside spawn. When you're spawning on the inside, this is going to be offense, and this is going to be the side you got to win one offense to win the game. You got to make sure you win all your defenses, and if you can win one offense, you're pretty much going to win this map if you're a good team. So, guy that spawns far right, this is going to be the first guy. Whoever spawns far right, it doesn't matter who you are, needs to go off the break. I like to go in this little corner, and I'll show you guys in a real mode, real-time situation. Come in this corner. Throw stuns through this top window right here. What that does is it lands a stun right out here, right here. Boom. Stuns the guy rushing up the middle. Like I said on the other side, it stops what I said on the other side. The guy rushing up the middle trying to get the sidewalk. And that's what you need to do for your teammate that I'm going to show you in the other position coming up.
Bomb acquired.
Alright, so now, the first guy is going to be going to the right window. Whoever spawns the far right is going to that window and is going to stun. Now, whoever spawns far left is going to want to use an SMG with extreme conditioning, pretty much like the other side. This is going to be the guy that's not going to be getting bumped. The guy's going to be able to get out there the quickest. So, he's going to be SMG with extreme conditioning. His route is going to be off the break, run over here to the left. Try to get outside. Look to the right. Don't even look down there. Don't even look down to the left over by B-bomb or any of that. Just go straight, and your mission is to get in this little cubby right here, because once you get in this cubby right here, then get the theater mode up there, then you can look through this crack right here, and when you see people cross, what will happen is the guy going in the middle, if he doesn't get naded by the guy stunning out that window, what he'll do is he'll cross right here, he won't even notice you, and he'll look over this head glitch, and he'll be sitting there. But you'll be able to see him through this crack, and you can poke out and kill him. It'll be the easiest kill ever, and your team will be able to get down to B. Once you get control of the sidewalk, then your teammates can start to push right here and start to push in this corner, and then they can work their way down to B. Alright, now the third guy on your team on this map, I'm going to say is going to want to be one of the more rusher types. I like to rush on this map on offense just because, like I said, it's one of the harder maps to win on offense if you get trapped in. So, either you're going to brush out and it's going to work, or you're going to get trapped in and you're just going to get killed anyway. So, there's no point to get trapped in. So, the third guy, what I like to do is follow the guy that's rushing sidewalk. The guy's rushing sidewalk, he's going to break to the right. What you're going to want to do is come to the left right here, stun over behind B-bomb. If you stun someone, then try to push up. But what you got to watch out for is people going behind the forklift, like I said, on the other side of the map. People like to go behind the forklift and wait. If he's not behind the forklift, then try to push down. Maybe he's behind red crates. So you got to watch out for that. And this is going to be where you really just help your team out. You know, if the guy can't get control of the sidewalk, everyone else is relying on you to kill this guy B, because then that's going to make B an open place and be able to push down with the bomb. And like I said, once you let people get set up behind bomb site or behind satellite or any of that, then it's going to be impossible to push this bomb site. You're not going to be able to pick them off. So I recommend coming over here stunning. If you don't stun anyone, then maybe post up right here and try to look sidewalk if you have an ACR or something and kill that guy. And if you don't have an ACR, then you're going to want to move and maybe hug this wall right here so you can't get killed. And just wait and see if your guy sidewalk can take the other guy out. Alright, now the last guy on the side is going to be playing a little bit slower. You know, he's going to want to use an ACR, maybe come back here. What I like to do is blow up this barrel inside the loading dock so you don't get stunned or naded and blow up by that piece of shit. And come over here with the ACR and look top dome, because sometimes people, you know, like I said on the other side on the break, people like to go top dome and lay up there. If you're sitting right here, maybe you can catch him off guard, but don't try to fight that if it's unnecessary. If there's a guy up there and he starts shooting at you, back down from that. You don't want to just sit there and fight that fight. You know, it's not really worth losing for your team. So, if there's no one up there, then what your job is going to be to do is slowly move out here to this semi right here. Maybe look through the middle crack. If there's a guy on your team who's already pushed down with the SMG, then you're going to want to push with him. But if he dies, then once again, you can try to get in this spot and try to kill people at the sidewalk. But if there's already got sidewalk, don't try to come to the spot, because he's just going to pick you off. It's going to be the easiest thing. And some of the best ways to kill the guy on sidewalk if you have an ACR is you can actually step up on this Humvee right here, or you can come behind the sandbag and you can snake out and try to kill the guy on sidewalk. So that's going to be some tips for you guys killing that guy. It's going to be a good head glitch, so you're going to have to be careful.
Bomb acquired.
Alright, so I'm going to have to break this episode into parts, because I'm going over four people's breaks, actually really eight people's, where when I'm doing the slaying and the objective, I'm really just going over what the slaying and the objective is going to do, so it's really just one player. So I'm going to have to do this in parts, because otherwise it's going to be like a 20-minute episode. As you see, this is already like 10 minutes long. So this episode covered the breaks. Next episode, I'll be going over the rushing spots and nades and what to do after you plant the bomb. I hope you guys enjoyed this. I hope you guys understand why I'm doing it in parts and understand that people don't want to watch a 20-minute episode. And if you guys like this, feel free to give it a like. And this is Sharp. I'm out. Peace.